We had travelled the Philippines for over 2 months now, and when we asked other travellers where their favourite place was, 9 times out of 10 they said Siargao. So what is causing this global buzz? In this video, we'll delve deep into all that Siargao has to offer, from exploring the top spots across the island on our own DIY land tour, attempting to immerse ourselves in the surf culture, and of course, we won't miss giving you a sneak peek into its vibrant party scene. Join us as we ride the Siargao wave.
Okay, so the first stop of today's island adventure is Coconut View Deck. I've just realised I've got my hat on in case any coconuts fall on my head, and the real reason is I don't know why I've got my hat on.
So it was a half an hour drive from General Luna area, and you literally pull over on the side of the road and you can see, hello, there's a pretty epic view across the road, so let's go check it out. So we are currently on our adventure with two new friends today. We've got Scotty from the UK but living in Australia. Oh, yeah. And how long are you in the Philippines for?
Another couple of weeks, I think.
A couple of weeks. And we've also got Lindsay from the USA. So if right I say on. If Hello. I say right on in the next couple of vlogs, it's because of Lindsay. And how long are you here for?
About 5 more days.
And you're from Florida, right?
From Florida.
So these are our two friends that we're traveling with today, so you'll see them in the vlog. An epic viewpoint, and Siargao is really well known for its coconut trees. There's a few stops with coconut trees along the way, but yeah, like panoramic views across the island with thousands of coconut trees, as you can imagine. So it's a beautiful stop off and a great photo opportunity.
Hey! Hey! Onwards with the adventure and upwards, hopefully.
We met Scott and Lindsay back in our hostel in Bohol. However, funny little backstory for you. Gaz and Scotty actually went on a group holiday to Ibiza about 6 years ago and met through a friend of a friend. They then never spoke or saw each other again, and then there he was in Bohol. It's crazy how travelling makes the world feel so small.
All right, so literally like a 2 minute drive down the street and you'll get to the Massam Bridge River Swing, which is one of the most popular and famous spots here in Siargao. You see it all over social media, you know, the swing with the palm trees, so excited to check it out. Lindsay's doing some shopping.
Ah, so cute.
There's so many cool little shops here, aren't there?
Right. Yeah, I'm gonna try these ones.
Okay.
Way down there.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. There is a massive jump into the river, but the lady warned me. She said that it's low tide at the moment, and she said, bend your knees as you're very tall, which is not something I get told very often, so I feel quite flattered by that.
Because it's low tide and you're very tall.
Yeah.
But yeah, I also might go and swim in it first, so
you can see how
to scope out, because if my feet can touch the floor, I'm not jumping off something that high.
Yeah, but it looks really beautiful, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It does look pretty high, actually.
Yeah. Not gonna lie, I expected it to be busier considering it's a Sunday, but it looks like you just got the local kids swimming in the water because they're not at school, so that's quite lucky.
I mean, two other people just jumped straight in, so I'm just gonna jump in. But yeah, probably about 5 or 6 metres, I reckon. Yeah, I'm just gonna do the jump and then have a little swim, have a little paddle.
Pretty high.
Pretty high. Cannonball, Gaz.
What?
Cannonball, so you don't knock your feet.
Ready?
Yeah.
Very high. Yeah, just go for it. 3, 2, 1.
Did you touch the floor?
Yeah.
A great start to the day. Get the adrenaline going and some time to just swim around and have a chat. It was so nice for me to have a female in the group who I gelled with too.
And you can also pay 20 pesos if you wish to get taken out on a raft. They love a raft out here for a photo opportunity. So I think it is very much it's all over Instagram, this spot, isn't it?
Yeah,
so,
but you see why, it's beautiful.
It is absolutely stunning.
The water's a little bit like twiggy and leafy though.
Yeah, but it's a river, isn't it?
Yeah,
so
yeah, yeah.
Be expected.
Well, I think it tastes of salt water. That's what my mouth tastes like anyway.
Ah, oh, Scotty's gone for a dip.
we missed your jump, mate.
Oh yeah, backflip.
Oh, Pete done a backflip. I'm going to have to do a backflip. We've now got two additional people in our group today, but that means we've got the travel group where like someone's getting a drink, someone's getting some water, we lost our bike key, and it takes about 20 minutes to leave, but it's all worth it for the good vibes.
I have to say, driving on Siargao's roads is an absolute dream. The most stunning scenery with palm trees everywhere, and the tarmac is perfect so you can go fast without stressing.
Wait. Hello.
Hello. So the next stop, which is slightly off the beaten track, I don't think people usually do this on the land tour, but we've made our own agenda today, as we know, is Tai An Ban Cave.
Essentially, we're about to go and like swim and walk through a cave. So we need a guide to do this, but yeah, I don't really know what to expect.
No, I don't either. 150 pesos per person, and then you have to mandatory get a guide, and you have to decide at the end how much you want to pay the guide. So there's like six of us now, and there's lots of questions going on. What have we missed here, Scotty?
Well, they're saying like it's up to your neck, but I'm like, if it's raining more, then won't it be entirely cold? So I'm a little bit apprehensive.
Is everyone in our group happy with this?
Extra.
Are you happy with the risk?
With what?
The risk?
Oh, yeah. The risk was calculated, even though I'm bad at math.
Gaz, what do you think? There's a lot of worried people here right now. Where are you guys from?
I'm from Cebu City.
And how long are you in Siargao for?
Like 5 days, 4 nights.
Hello.
From Brisbane?
Brisbane, Australia, I represent.
Woohoo! And you're here for 2 weeks, aren't you?
Yeah, correct.
But you're from the Philippines?
Yes, born and raised in the Philippines.
So these are the other two that have joined our group, so you'll see them in our tour as well now.
I'm shitting my pants a bit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The thought of it raining and then...
I don't like caves, and I'm not very good at swimming.
Ah, we got loads of puppies to calm me down though. Yeah. Are you going to take it off then?
No, I'm keeping it on.
We get a torch and everything, God.
We did try these, I hope.
So that's Filipino for respect.
Yeah.
Kuya.
Up here, the water.
Ah.
Oh, wow.
Right, okay.
Shine your light on a loser.
I can't get my light on.
Oh, it's cold.
Oh,
we're going in. Okay. Whoa, we're actually going caving, guys.
And he said to put your head in the water. With the flashlight on.
Yep, that was the instruction.
Okay, cool.
Oh, there you go.
Although there was a lot of pent-up nerves before the cave, we needn't worry. It was dark and there was some pretty small spaces, but we all goofed around so much that there was no room to feel scared.
Every night in my dreams.
I'm raving.
Disco cave.
Especially with your jacket on. Next stop, we headed into a very dark area with lots of bats.
It smells like bat poo as well, doesn't it? Can you smell that? That is bat poo.
Oh my God, there's so many bats. Jesus. Oh my God, there's so many. Oh my God, there's actually two.
I did not just scream like a girl. So, there are hundreds of bats on the ceiling. So far, it's so dark when you turn your lights off, there's a bat.
Isn't it me?
I don't know, I'm not looking. But yeah, this is actually awesome. It's genuinely so cool.
Yeah.
Like, and it does feel pretty safe. Like, there's a rope taking you all the way around. We've got a guide.
We can't stand though.
No. but there's rocks that you can kind of sit on. Anyway, I'm turning my light back on because I'm scared. Do the bats like the disco?
So we're now heading down the corridor, we're out the water, and there's a little hole with some light at the end. We've got through the bat section and then back in the water, I think. But yeah, it's really cool.
I'm having a great time, yeah.
This is just a random stop. I was like, if people want to do it, everyone was like, yeah, let's do it. So it's cool.
This is cool.
It is cool.
It's going to be hard to kind of show how cool it is, but take our word for it.
Yeah. What are we wowing about?
It's like a open lagoon out through here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This is cool. I said I expected rope swings. Alas, another one. Lindsay just said, there's so many jumping off things here, and I agree.
So many jumping and swinging things.
Yeah. Anything high adrenaline, guys, the Philippines is your place.
Don't jump,
up
your knee.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3,
go.
Woo!
Jump!
Yeah, epic, bloody epic. We actually ended up across the road on the other side.
Yeah, so we went underneath the cave under the road. Next stop is Pacifico Beach, which apparently is really good for surfing. Obviously we are on Siargao, but we didn't know that it was meant to be like famous for surfing, so we've just been swamped by.
I think this is the one that doesn't have like the coral reef that General Luna does. So for beginners like me and Abby, it's probably a lot better to
come surf
surfing for. So I think we'll come back for that.
Yeah. But as soon as we arrived, everyone like pulled up and was like,
"Surfing! Hey. Hello! I'm blessed.
But yeah, we want some food first because we haven't eaten all day. It's like 3 o'clock, so that's the plan. Food first, then beach and have a look around.
Yeah.
Pasta. Whatever. Right, choice made, guys. Whoa, is that a... Is that like for skateboarding?
I mean, what?
Like a skate,
can anyone skateboard?
Do you guys know how to skate?
I know how to skate.
No, do you know how to skate?
I don't know how to skate.
No.
So what was your specialty, Scotty?
Chorizo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cheers.
You should all cheers.
Where's yours?
Cheers.
The mango shakes are out in full force.
Yeah. My chorizo silog.
Ooh. Ooh, silog.
Ooh.
A chorizo pizza. It looks delicious. A homemade pizza.
Don't give it away.
It's a good one.
Spicy or not?
Got a little bit of kick to it, but nothing. Nothing like, yeah. Doesn't blow your socks off, but that's not what I want.
Although every stop today has been so fun, the best part for us was definitely getting to know everyone. Chatting to people with different upbringings who have new perspectives on the world is so refreshing and honestly our favourite part of travel.
Got a friend. Pretty tasty, now time to check out the actual beach we came here for.
I've heard it's para.
Paradise.
I made the worst mistake ever of wearing my shoes, my trainers and socks into the bloody cave diving water thing.
What's Lindsay doing? Lindsay, what are you doing?
I feel like we could take a really cool photo on the beach with this thing.
Okay, let's go. Yeah, it looks good, doesn't it?
You want fresh coconut? Cold?
No. Ooh, good, thank you. This is nice.
It's
you can
nice.
See. Yeah, it's like calm here and then a good break there for the oars. Maybe we'll come back here because we're going to do a full day on surfing, aren't we, Gaz? So not surfing today, but we'll probably come back to this beach.
Chunky dog.
So we are just sat chilling on the beach watching the surfs, aren't we, Gaz? I feel like we knew Siargao was going to be a surf town because obviously that's what it's known for.
Not how much of it, though.
Yeah, yeah, literally everyone surfs. Everyone has proper cool fashion sense as well. And there's me and my scruffy, like, cotton shorts. Makes me want to buy, like, nice clothes. The food's super healthy. Yeah,
it's like Bali.
It is like Bali.
It's essentially Bali.
Yeah, it's what people say Bali's like. But it's really, really, yeah, it's really nice. It's got a cool vibe, doesn't it?
Yeah. Hello.
Hi, vlog.
Hi.
Welcome to my paradise.
Yeah. Next up, let's go.
What is the beach called? What's the name? Yeah.
Name?
Yeah.
Mag Pokongo.
Mag Pokongo.
Mag Pokongo. Okay.
Mag Pokongo. Thank you. I'll say it very quickly. Thanks for that. So we've made it to Mag Pokongo Beach. I keep getting the absolute worldie of names to say, which is where essentially like really good looking rock pools. Now, usually in the day, you have to pay 60 pesos per person and 5 pesos per bike to actually get down here, but we managed to swerve that because we're late.
Yeah, they finished for the day. Oh, there's some drinks, there's preps. Oh, this is a really little cute little place, isn't it? So where is said rock pool, guys? Over that way?
Yep.
Cool. It's a nice beach though, isn't it? Beautiful. I think it's just around that corner there.
So we've got to walk either around or through the water to get there. My feet are already soaking wet in these, so I'm just going to try and get around there, then take my shoes off.
Yeah, same.
You can see we have to come here at low tide. We've been asking that all day, haven't we? High tide, low tide. Because essentially this would all be underwater, like most of the day.
Is that because the tide would be in?
Yeah, so when it's... I don't know.
Yeah.
Are you standing there?
What?
Are you standing?
Yeah, I feel like, I don't know, it looks a bit high tide, doesn't it? You can't really see it. Like, I swear it's meant to... Unless, like, there's a few of these around on the internet, so maybe there's a couple more that aren't like this. But it essentially drops off, it's like a little scale of a reef, and then it's like little pools, like hot tub pools. But yeah, we're going to get in, take the GoPro. Let's go.
So we actually think that the water is still going out, so hopefully in 10-15 minutes or so it will look more like a lagoon and the rock pools that we thought it would. But yeah, pretty cool anyway.
So we are currently sat next to some turquoise, whoa, rock pools.
Getting watching, battered by the waves.
No, watching the sunset and just loving life. We've had a great day, haven't we, Gaz? I think travelling, we haven't travelled within a group for ages. We've only really travelled like us two, maybe one other person. Oh my gosh, now we're getting battered by the waves. There's a massive one coming as well.
Oh God.
Yeah, so the highlight has been... I feel like I'm trying to have a DMC here and it's just not working,
yeah.
Is it? Yeah, the highlight has been travelling with a big group. It's been really, really fun today. And it's been well easy to do the land tour by yourself, so make sure you do that.
An epic first day with a great group of people. Next on our Siargao itinerary was to give surfing a go. Not something I was the most confident about.
First stop of the day before we hit the waves, dude, is... Abby's laughing because I've automatically turned into a surfer gnarly man. But anyway, first stop is to fuel ourselves. So we're checking out this really vibey little, what's it called?
It's called Shaka Cafe, which is the top rated place to get a smoothie bowl here in Siargao.
They don't do bacon and egg?
No, just really, really beautiful.
Nah, I'm joking,
lots of ratings as well, so it's going to be tasty.
Yeah.
Do you want to sit in the sun or in the shade?
Shade, man.
All right.
100%.
Yeah. It's a crack.
So you can get like a bowl and coffee for free at 80.
All right.
But the menus, you have to order up there, so...
Oh, should we just go and have a look?
Yeah, yeah, I know what I want, but do you want to go and have a look?
Ultimate energy beats banana, peanut butter, cacao. Well, that's a bit chocolatey, isn't it? Green apple.
Well, I'll say mine. Can I get this?
Bom dia.
Okay, sir. Ah, yeah, please. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Gone for the acai ones and it looks absolutely beautiful. A little flower of mango on top here, which is good. No granola for me because gluten-free life. But yeah, they're really beautiful. Let's taste it. It's nice, proper refreshing. Nice and healthy, like the lifestyle here.
This cafe is right next to Cloud 9, a very popular surfing spot, world famous for its thick hollow tubes and fast barreling right-hand waves. As you eat your smoothie bowls, you can see the surfers dashing in and out of the water, looking very cool. Certainly not a spot for me and Gaz to try surfing though.
Right, a very, very tasty breakfast, and now we've got an hour drive to get to one of the beginner beaches. Okay, an hour's drive north and we've made it to Pacifico Beach. We've just sat down, found a little spot, but this is the best one for beginner surfing because there's no sharp rocks underneath, so when you fall, you're not going to scrape your body or feet or anything on the floor. We can't believe that some of the beginner ones around the general lunar area have that. Like, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to fall elegantly. I'm going to bash my head off the floor, probably. We've met our two friends again, Lindsay and Scotty. They're out on the waves. It looks pretty good, to be fair.
I don't know why everybody's like congregating in one spot as well. I guess that's where the best waves are, or we're about to find out.
Thank you.
Two or one?
Two boards, please, and the largest one as well. A big one, too, for me.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Yeah. Beginner two. Oh, I'm gonna have to grab it.
Thank you.
Thank you. You got it?
Yes. I hope so.
Thank you.
You just want to do 1 hour now?
Yeah, and then we can ask for another hour,
yeah?
If we want it.
Okay. Just 1 hour, yeah. Pay now or when we come back?
No.
Yeah. How much?
400.
Okay. How was it?
Absolutely dumped on.
Did ya?
So much.
Is it hard?
Yeah, if you go to the 3-foot ones.
Did you ride some waves though?
A couple. Not very successfully though.
We're going. I don't even know how to pick up my surfboard. It feels so wrong in my arm.
The first issue.
It's trying to get in the sea. An instructor, by the way, that like pushes you onto the waves and shows you where to go, but we don't want it. I don't know why we don't want to. I don't even think it's expensive either. Right, I'm on the board.
But go on, do some swimming on it.
This is what we thought we'd look like surfing. And here is what we really looked like.
I just got a wave, but I didn't film it, and it was completely unintentional. Like, I didn't paddle in the slightest. Go on, guys. No. No.
Go on. Go on. No. Oh shit. Well, I'm gonna go for it. Oh. Too late.
I would have caught that.
So I've been out here for about half an hour and so far I've caught a grand total of zero waves, but I'm enjoying it nonetheless, watching all of the pros do their thing.
Little did we know at the time, but this girl here is actually a really famous surfer, longboarder and model. I mean, we should have guessed because she was insane, absolutely stunning, and didn't even get her hair wet the whole time she was in the water. When we got back to the hostel later, we also saw they had a mural of her painted on the front of the building. I spent most of my time just watching her.
Oh my God, I'm about to get battered again.
So it was a reality check for sure, but so fun nonetheless. Our advice would be to get an instructor if you're really serious about wanting to learn, but we just had fun flailing around and watching the pros at work. We have such respect for anyone that has mastered this sport, as you have to have some serious skill just to be able to stand up. A great afternoon and one we would recommend to you all. The next day we booked ourselves onto
a booze cruise.
So we booked the island hopping tour through Happiness Hostel, and it's actually their first ever party cruise that we're doing today. It was 1,800 pesos, and apparently all booze is included or until it runs out. So of course we've bought an emergency bottle of rum with us just in case, but there's a real buzz around the hostel today. We're buzzing and we're really looking forward to an exciting day of seeing the sights and having a few drinks. Let's go.
Okay, so it's time for welcome shots.
Cheers! Oh, yeah.
Cheers! Cheers!
Can we get one more? There's one more. Starts from there. There you go.
You like
more? No, I'll wait. Thank you.
Oh my gosh,
how are
they?
A short tricycle ride to the pier, and now we're heading down onto the boat. First drink has been poured, it's serve your own booze, and we're just waiting for the guy to get signed off from the Coast Guard, and then we'll be on the sea, not on the road.
Sea, on the road, on the sea.
Yes!
So off we went. What I loved was there's no warm-up for the Filipinos. As soon as the music started and the boat was moving, they were dancing. For us, on the other hand, it takes a few more drinks. First stop, we docked just near Naked Island. The music was blasting by our DJ, people were jumping in, and the vibes were on point. Throughout the day, we made three stops in the sea before heading to the bridge for sunset. As you can imagine, things got more messy as the day progressed, and the party got crazy. Siargao's drinking scene was probably one of the best we'd had in the Philippines. Each night they had one place which is a designated bar for everyone to party at. From beach clubs, disco house, full moon parties, they seemed to have it all, and it was always heaving with people. It's a great place if you're looking for a lively, fun atmosphere, but you can also easily avoid it if you just go to another bar that isn't the chosen one for that evening. It seems to cater for everyone. It's easy to see why Siargao is getting all the attention as a top spot for tourists worldwide. This island has something for everyone, from heart-pounding adventures to those perfect Instagram snaps, or just kicking back on the beach. And of course, the crazy nightlife. Whether you fancy a chill acoustic bar or dancing until the early hours in the morning, Siargao seems to tick every box, and we will definitely be coming back. This isn't our only video on Siargao. Next, we'll be checking out his famous island hopping tour and seeing if it is truly worth the hype. So make sure you hit subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you like the video, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!